So example two says we have container A, which is this one, and container B. They have two different gases, and we allow both of these gases to funnel into a new container, container C. Just to let you know, it's not drawn to scale. All these gases in here are in here. Even though I don't show all of them, they're considered all of them to be in there. All the gases here are also in here. Now, based on the image of container C, what is the sign of entropy, delta S? And here, this little zero here just means standard conditions. When we say standard conditions, we mean one atmosphere and 25 degrees Celsius. That's our standard state when we're talking about thermodynamics. Don't get confused. We also dealt with standard conditions when we deal with gases. We say STP. Now, STP for gases is different. Under those standard conditions, that pressure is still one atmosphere, but the temperature is 0 degrees Celsius. When we're talking about spontaneity and thermodynamics, the new temperature now becomes 25 degrees Celsius. Now, just think about it like this. Delta S is chaos. The more disorder, the better. So we have one container filled with gases. We have a second container filled with gases. We take those two containers, which are very chaotic, and dump them all together into an even bigger container where they can just mix around even more, bouncing all over the place. So ask yourself, if I take both gases and I put them together, will the entropy increase or decrease? I have a party of 100 people. I have another party of 100 people. I take them and now I have a party of 200 people. Will they get even crazier together than apart? That's how you have to think of it. We're gonna say here, the more gases you put in, the crazier things are gonna get because they're gonna be bouncing around the wall because there are even more of them. So we're gonna say here, entropy is positive. So we should get a positive entropy when we mix gases together because we're causing greater disruption, greater chaos. Now that we've done examples one and examples two, I want you guys to at least attempt to do this following practice question. And I'll give you guys a few hints. So here we're saying an ideal gas is allowed to expand at constant temperature. What are the signs for delta H, delta S, and delta G? First of all, for delta S, remember, S is chaos, entropy. Here, the gases in A are becoming like the gases in B. They transition and now they become like the picture in B. Ask yourself, since the gases have more room to bounce around, will their entropy increase or decrease? Next, delta G. I'll tell you this, delta G, when it's negative, it's spontaneous. When it's positive, it's non-spontaneous. So ask yourself this, an ideal gas is a gas that wants enough room for itself. Based on that information, is delta G positive or negative? Finally, delta H is enthalpy. Enthalpy is just the measurement of a reaction if it absorbs energy or if it releases energy. And when we talk about energy, we're talking about heat energy in this case. So, if it's absorbing energy, it's going to be positive. If it's releasing energy, it's going to be negative. I say constant temperature. So what's the sign of delta H when we realize that we're at constant temperature? These little hints will help you figure out what the answer is. And don't worry, if you can't figure it out, just come back and click on the explanation button, and you'll see a video of me explaining how to approach this problem. Good luck, guys.